Hi guys, in today's video we're going to talk about printing your patterns, and not just the correct way to do it, but also not. That's right, we're going rogue, so let's jump right in. I've opened up the Sunshine Crossbody pattern in Adobe Reader, and we're going to look at how to correctly print it according to the pattern's instructions. The first thing I would suggest doing is finding the page that has the test piece on it. It's usually on one of the pattern piece pages, and print only that page. So you're going to scroll down through the pattern until you find it, and in this case, it's on page 23. And you can see it's the 2-inch test square here. So you're going to click the print icon, and this opens up the print dialog box. So for sizing, you're going to look at page sizing and handling, and either select actual size or custom scale, and make sure that it's set to 100%. We're going to come back to this section later. So to print only this page, with that page showing on the screen, you can select current page, or you can select pages and type in the page number. And then click print. I've already printed mine, so I'll meet you over at the sewing counter and we'll go over how to measure that. Okay, so we have our page printed and I have it over here at my countertop. So I have several rulers here. You can pretty much use any of these rulers. The only thing that I would not recommend using, unless it's the only thing that you have, is one of the flexible tapes for measuring for garments and that type of thing. You really want something solid. I personally prefer to have an acrylic ruler because you can see through these and you can place that right over top of the test square and see that it lines up perfectly. So we know that this page is printed at 100% or actual size. If you want to measure it again against a second ruler just to make sure that the first ruler was accurate, then you can do that, and it is. So now that you know that the test square matches up, and this is in fact printed at actual size or 100%, you can go ahead and print the rest of the pattern. If you want to skip this page, you can do that by selecting the pages and typing in the page numbers from 1 up to this page, and then comma, and then the next page, so 24 through the last page. Or you can just print the whole thing. I personally typically only print the pattern pages to save paper, and then I just refer back to my computer when I need to see the instructions. Let's go back over to the computer and talk about not printing in actual size. We're back over at the pattern, and I want to talk to you about a couple of different ways to change the dimension of the project that you're making. So the first one that I want to talk about is by a percentage, and this is the most commonly used method to change the size of a pattern. So I'm going to go back up and open my print dialog box again. So let's say we want to make this bag a little bit smaller than what the pattern calls for. So I'm going to make sure I'm still on that print page, which is page 23 in this pattern. And under custom scale, I'm going to type in 75% and select print. Now this is going to print it at 75%. And then we can go from there by measuring the test square, making sure that it's correct size, and then going ahead and printing the rest of your pattern, just as we did before for the 100%. Alternately, let's say that bag won't quite fit all the things you normally carry, so you want to make it larger. Well, this is where we run into an issue, because it just fits on the page at 100%. How are we going to get it to fit on the page at 150%? Well, we're not without taking it to a custom print shop. So in this case, we're going to select poster. Under tile scale, type in 150 for 150%, and make sure that we're still on the correct page, the one that has that test square, because again, we're going to need to measure that before we print the entire pattern. That's a lot of paper to have to waste if it doesn't print correctly. So we're going to select print, and then I'm going to meet you over at the counter, and we're going to compare all three, the 75%, the 100%, and the 150%, and make sure that they've all printed correctly. Okay, we're back over at the counter with our three test prints. We have our 75%, 100%, and 150% prints. So the first thing we need to do is test to make sure that these printed correctly. Always, always, always test them. So the original test square, of course, is 2 inches at 100%. So for the 75% one to be accurate, that means our test square needs to be 1.5 inches now. And it is. So for the 150%, that means our test square should be 3 inches. And it is. So if you wanted to make the pattern at either one of these sizes, that's how you would print it. So now we're going to talk about something a little bit different. We're going to talk about changing the one dimension of a pattern. So say you have, for instance, the Lola, which is one of my favorite patterns to make. I've actually never made the Lola at original size. So I have this bag, which is currently listed in my shop. This is one of the Lolas that I've made. It is the exact dimensions in all ways except one from the original pattern. It's still got a 6-inch gusset on the bottom. It's still the same height, but it's 2 inches wider than the original pattern calls for. And I'm going to show you how I did that. All right, so we're going to start with our pattern piece. This is just a general shape that I've drawn out that's similar to the Lola that I'd mentioned, but it does not reflect the actual size of the pattern pieces in that pattern. I'm also going to cut about a 2-inch wide section of paper. Okay, now that we have the two pieces that we need to expand the pattern, let's talk about how we do that. So this is the main body panel of this pattern that I'm working on. And if I want that pattern to be 2 inches wide, then what I'm going to do is add an inch to the middle, because obviously this piece is going to be cut on the fold. So I'm going to take my strip of paper here, and I'm going to mark off an inch, just with a pen. And I'm going to take that, flip it around, and put my pattern piece beneath it, or on top of it, and line the edge of the pattern piece up with that line that I made, and then I'm going to put a piece of tape on it. I'm just going to use some masking tape because it happens to be what I have handy here. So now that we've done that, I'm going to take my scissors and as closely as possible, follow the line of the pattern at both the top and the bottom. And that's it. You've just made your bag 2 inches wider. Was that not really simple to do? And this will apply to a lot of different patterns, as long as it has a fairly consistent shape, especially if the bag has a flat top. You could make it 10 inches wider if you wanted to. I'm not sure why you'd want to, but hell, if you want to, go for it. But really simple. All right, so let's say that you want your pattern to be a little bit taller. Well, we can do that too, depending on the pattern. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Let's see if it'll work in this case, or see if we can make it work. So I'm going to line up one of my lines on my ruler here. And I'm going to take my X-Acto knife. And I'm going to cut it. And I'm going to take another of my scrap pieces from earlier. And I'm going to cut off about a 2-inch section again. So now, let's say we want this pattern to be an inch taller than it was before. So we've got 2 inches here. We want to make sure that we overlap a 1/2 inch on one side and a 1/2 inch on the other. And I'm going to speculate that it's not going to be a great method to use for this pattern. For a pattern that's tall and straight, it would absolutely work well. In this case, we can make it work. So I'm going to take my piece. I'm going to line it up with this right edge, just to make sure that I've got my top and bottom pieces lined up correctly. Alternately, another way you could do it is actually, we can take our two pieces and move them until they're at a point that these two sides line up. Granted, this isn't only going to change one dimension of the bag, it's going to change two. It will slightly alter that middle line. But now your edge is lined up. What we can do is take a straight edge, go on the line that's the shortest, and try not to botch it. There we go. So now this bag pattern is an inch taller and almost an inch wider than it was originally. So there are other ways to change the dimensions of your pattern without having to use a percentage. This way, the bottom gusset of the bag is going to stay the same. So I encourage you to play around. That's what I did, and I've come up with some pretty good bags out of it. So that's going to be it for this video today, guys. If you have any ideas or questions for me, please absolutely post those in the comment section below. If there's anything that you'd like to see that you're curious about, let me know, and we can add that to the list of future videos. So I'll see you next time, guys. Thank you so much for spending a little bit of your day with me.